Hey guys, my name's Dave and welcome to another Guitar Zero to Hero song tutorial. In this lesson, I'm going to teach you how to play Die For You by Bring Me the Horizon. It's an awesome track and it's got a cool guitar solo in it as well. For the basics of this song, you'll just need your guitar in standard tuning. Now, I'm pretty sure in the studio recording they have their guitars drop tuned, but you can play this in standard tuning and it sounds just as good. So let's jump into the lesson. All right, so I'll start by teaching you the intro. Now, in terms of tone, I've just got a clean amp channel here. I'm using the neck pickup and I've got some reverb and delay. Now, if you're using a Boss Katana Mark II, I'll leave a link to the tone patches in the description. Now, we're gonna start with this particular shape. So this is based around a B minor. So we just have 7th fret of the 6th and 3rd strings with your index and middle finger like this. Now, I'm gonna be using hybrid picking for this particular intro riff. So what that means is I'm gonna pluck the 6th string with my pick, but also use my middle finger here to pluck the 3rd string at the same time. Like that. Pluck that and hold out for a full bar. 1, 2, 3, 4. For the next bar, we shift this exact shape up to the 9th fret. We're gonna hold this out for 1.5 beats. So 1, 2. On the end bit after 2, we go up to this D shape. So it's 11th and 12th frets. So at no point do we lift our fingers. We're just sliding them back and forth on the 6th and 3rd strings. So we have 10th and 11th fret here. So this is based around a D chord. Hold that for 1.5 beats as well. And then we go down to this F sharp minor. So 2nd fret on the 4 beat. So this bar in total, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then we end on a G shape. So it's 3rd and 4th frets here. We're gonna hold this out for 1.5 bars. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. On the 3 beat, we then go up to the A shape. So it's just the same shape up 2 frets, 5th and 6th frets. So the first line of tab. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now the second line of tab is almost identical, except we do not move up to this A shape. We just hold on to this G shape and that's it for the intro. So the next section is that heavy break before the first verse, and it's really nice and easy. We're just playing power chords here. So the first power chord is a B5 power chord. Now you can just play it like a regular B5 power chord like this, or what we can do is add an extra note to make this sound a whole lot more fat. Now I'm pretty sure in the actual studio recording they have detuned guitars playing that really low B5 power chord, but the lowest B5 power chord we can get on standard tuning is that. But to make it sound almost as if it were in that lower octave, all you can do is add the lower octave of the 5th. So with the B5, we have the B and the F sharp. If we add the lower F sharp, so just the same note above the 5th string root note, add that extra note and it sounds a lot more fat. So that's B5, and that's B5 with the F sharp in the bass. So that's a little trick if you want to fatten up any of your power chords. If you're playing any power chord with the root on the 5th string, like D for example, if you add the lower octave of the 5th, so it's just the note one string up from the 5th string root, it makes it sound a lot more fat. So anyway, back to the chord progression. We have that B5 power chord, and we're gonna add that extra F sharp root, and then we have a G5 power chord, and then we have an A, which is 2 frets up, and then we have an E. So from this shape, we'll just slide our ring and pinky finger down to the 2nd fret and have that open 6th string. Now the strumming pattern's gonna be down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, down, up. Now there's gonna be 2 chords for each strumming pattern, and the point at which we'll change chords is on the highlighted down strum. So it will sound like this. And that's it for the break section, but it's also the same as the choruses. So you can just use those power chords in the choruses and also for the solo rhythm. The next section is verse number 2. So we're just going to take those power chords from the chorus and the break, and we're just going to be palm muting them. For the B5, we will just focus on the 5th and 4th strings though. Now in terms of timing, You're going to play this B5 up until the end bit after the 2, and then we'll switch to the G5. And the same thing happens for the A5 to the E5. We will be palm muting those chords, so take the fleshy bit of your palm and rest it lightly on the edge of the bridge as you pluck those power chords with the downstroke. And you'll get that nice chunky palm mute sound. So 1, 2, 3. So that's played through twice. We're going to play the same chords, but now our strumming pattern sort of differs. We're going to alternate between hitting the chord like normal and then palm muting the bass note. So we're going to do 3 times for the B and then 5 times for the G. And then the same thing for the A to the E. So. And then for the next line of tab, we'll just be hitting the bass notes continuously with a down up motion. We'll just be hitting those individual strings and the timing will be the same as well. So change on the end beat after 2. But when we get to the A, we're just going to pluck that with 8 plucks and then pause. So this third line of tab, 1, 2. And that's it for the verse 2 rhythm. For the verse 2 lead, we have something that goes like this. So pinky finger on the 14th fret of the 3rd string, middle finger on the 12th fret of the 3rd string. Now we're gonna be palm muting all these notes as well. So lightly put your palm on the edge of the bridge as you pluck these notes. So we're gonna alternate between the 3rd and 4th string. We're gonna do that twice. And then lift your pinky finger and have your index finger on the 11th fret of the 3rd string. Alternate those two strings one more time. So those 6 plucks. Now we're going to repeat that again. And then to end this bar, we go down to the 9th fret. We pluck that and then 11th, back down to 9th. And then we go to the 12th fret. Yeah. Like that. And this first bar. And then for the second bar, we go 11th, 12th, 11th, 12th. So. And then 14th fret of the 3rd string. And then 12th, 11th, 12th, 11th, 12th, 14th fret of the 3rd string. Then 4th string, 3rd string, then 12th fret, 11th, and back to 12th. So it might seem a bit confusing, but just follow along on the tab. So this second bar. And this line of tab in total. Now for the next line of tab, we're going to play some octave shapes. So it's the same as a power chord, except you lift your ring finger. So it's just the root note and the octave above it. And ideally what you do is rest your index finger across all the other strings so that the only notes that ring out are those 2 notes of the octave. So we're going to strum the 5th and 7th fret octave here and then move up 2 frets. So we're going to start with a strum on the 5th and 7th. And then on the next up strum, we slide it up 2 frets and continue strumming. And then we go back down to 5th and go back up to 7th and 9th again. And we're going to continue strumming to the end of this bar. So from the start. And then for the second bar, we do the exact same thing, but we just play for half the bar. And the line in total. And that's it for the second verse lead. Okay, so now I'm going to teach you how to play the solo. So there's 2 lines of tab here. We're going to start on the 15th fret of the 2nd string. And then we'll go to the 17th. And then 17th fret of the 1st string. And then back to the 17th fret of the 2nd string. So 4 notes there. And then the next lick goes like this. 17th fret of the 1st string. 15th of the 2nd. Down to 14th. But we're going to hit it and bend it up and release down with a half beat, like that, so. And then we end on the 14th fret of the 3rd string, so. And the bar in total. For the next lick, with our index finger already here, we're gonna bar it across that 14th fret, hit the 14th fret of the second string, 15th, 17th, and back down to 14th of the third. And then for our next phrase, we're just gonna go to the 17th fret, hit it and bend up a full tone, and then back to the 14th fret of the third string. So, and then to continue on, we go 15th fret of the second, 14th, 17th fret of the second, 14th of the third, and then 14th fret of the second, and 15th. So that last bit. And the first line of tab in total. For the second line of tab, we're going to start 15th fret of the second string, then 17th, then 17th fret of the first string, hit it and bend up and release, and then down to 15th fret of the second, 14th, 15th, 14th, 14th fret of the third string, and then hit the 17th fret and slide up to 19th. And so far, and then we have one really quick lick here, which is played in triplets. So we're gonna go 14th fret of the third string, 16th, then 14th fret of the second string, 15th and 17th twice. So, and that bar in total. And for the final bar, we go down to the 7th fret of the 3rd string. Then we're going to hit 7th, 9th, 7th. And then we're going to hit the 9th, but bend up and release. So it's a full bend and release. And then go back down to 7th fret. And then take your ring finger to 6th fret. We're going to do a bend and release, but a half bend. And then down to 4th. And then down to 7th fret of the 4th string twice. And then hit the 5th fret of the 2nd string and 7th. So that phrase in total. And the whole solo in total. And those are all the parts that you need to learn. So now I'll be doing a full playthrough of the song, so feel free to play this back as many times as you'd like to practice playing along to and see how you go. You know that I died for, I cried for, you know that I died for you. You know that I grieve for, I bleed for, you know that I grieve for you. Have you seen my halo, even though it's painful? We'll be right back.
crash. This isn't love, this is a bloodbath. This isn't love, this is a sentence. It's a bullet in the head. This isn't love, this is a car crash. This isn't love, this is a bloodbath.
Thanks so much for watching. If you've enjoyed this lesson, then I know you'll absolutely love these other lessons too. So hit the link here. Or if you want to grab a copy of my free guitar ebook, then head over to guitarzerotohero.com or click the link here. Thanks so much, and I'll see you guys next time on Guitar Zero to Hero. Cheers.